Toinen tarjokas Suomen ilmavoimille uudeksi hävittäjäkoneeksi täältä Yhdysvalloista olevista tarjokkaista on tämä F-35 Lightning II Lockheed Martin -tuote. Ei ole kauhean kaunis, mutta siitä se ei ole kovin tärkeää. Kone on erittäin kallis. Se on edelleen osittain työn alla. Sitä ei ole testattu tosi toimissa, mutta se on todella kiinnostava. Ja etenkin kaikki tekniikasta innostuneet nörtit, kuten minä, ovat tästä kovin innostuneita. Mutta onko se hintansa väärä? Se on sitten toinen asia, ja sitä tutkitaan nyt.
A pilot term that you, if you ask any pilots flying the airplane currently, they'll use the adjective easy. Mm-hmm. And easy translates to a pilot to be predictable. I don't need to worry about it. The airplane and the flying portion of the airplane are things I don't really have to worry about. The safety of the airplane I don't have to worry about nearly as much as I used to with other airplanes. So now I can concentrate on all the information that's coming into me, and in a fifth generation airplane, that's the game changer. That's the quantum leap in capability. When we combine for fifth generation aircraft, when we combine the stealth characteristics of an airplane, our sensor fusion characteristics of how we get information, bring information in, assimilate that information to the pilot, and not only my airplane, but the airplanes flying with me, and even the ability to now connect to people of importance on the ground, commanders, other entities in flight, other entities wherever they might be in the service that's using the airplane. That connectivity really sets fifth generation airplanes apart. It allows me, the pilot, any pilots that fly this airplane, to now become tacticians versus technicians, if that makes sense. So what you can see is, as you look at it, you can see the shape. You can actually see how we have built these stealth characteristics into the airplane. This is not something, when we talk about stealth, that you can slap on and add to a fourth gen airplane and create the same kind of capabilities. This is something that has to be designed in from the beginning. For instance, as you look at the airplane, you notice that the wings and the tails are aligned, that the edges are aligned, that we don't necessarily have fuel tanks, even though this airplane can hold 18,000 pounds of fuel, which is about three times the amount of fuel that an internal carriage of an F-16 can do. We carry our weapons internally inside these weapon bays that are open. And if I had the covers off the intakes, you wouldn't be able to see the face of the engine. That gives us stealth characteristics. So as you look at the airplane, we have probably the most capable radar that we've put in fighters, at least in the United States, in this airplane. In fact, it's so capable we don't even call it a radar, we call it a multifunction array. There are so many things it can do. We have that in the nose of the airplane. That system talks to not only the pilot, but it also talks to other systems in the airplane. This piece of machinery, if you will, is called our electro-optical targeting system. In fourth generation airplanes, we've become accustomed to carrying targeting pods, flare pods. So, but that technology is some of the new technology that we've put into this airplane, as well as things that we call electro-hydrostatic actuators, okay? So, you see the control surfaces, you see this horizontal stabilator, or this control surface right here. This bump is a piece of machinery that's never really flown on airplanes before. What we do is we send a signal to a piece of machinery that then converts that signal into hydraulic power right at the source. That hydraulic power then moves that control surface. So that's a new technology that we've put on this airplane. Instead of running hydraulic fluid all through the airplane to power the systems and everything, we only run the hydraulic system at the source. And if you take nothing else away from what I tell you today, Suffice it to say that in my estimation, this weapon system platform is the most flexible and adaptable platform we have ever created for a fighter. And what that translates to a fighter pilot is, it means that it's the most survivable and lethal platform that we've ever created for a fighter aircraft.
Chester 6-1, stand by.
F-35 on koko nimeltään F-35 Lightning II. Sen on suunnitellut ja sitä tekee Lockheed Martin yhtiö Fort Worthissa, Texasissa. Koneen saaminen palveluskäyttöön kesti paljon suunniteltua kauemmin ja niistä tuli paljon laskettua kalliimpia. Syynä tähän on yksinkertaisesti se, että kone käyttää uusinta, saatavilla olevaa tekniikkaa ja vähän sitä enemmänkin, ja koneen kanssa on siksi ollut hieman ongelmia. Tässä ovatkin koneen hyvät ja huonot puolet. Se on huippumoderni, mutta siksi se on kallis ja siinä on lastentauteja. Koneesta on tehty myös versio lentotukialuskäyttöön, mutta Suomeen on tarjolla niin sanottu A-malli, perusmalli, joita on tilattu myös täällä Euroopassa, Hollantiin, Italiaan, Tanskaan ja Norjaan.
We've been here close to 2 years. This summer Norway has been here for 2 years. And we've had Norwegian aircraft here for 1.5 years. Right now we have 4 F-35s. The plan is for Norway to have 7 F-35s in the time when we're going to be converting and training new maintainers and pilots on the F-35. So Norway has, we're pretty early in the program, and right now we're training not just pilots, we're also training maintainers. We're training people on the simulator, life support personnel. We're essentially training every single category of person needed to operate the F-35 in Norway here at Luke.
So the flight equipment for the F-35 pilots consists of essentially 3 pieces. It's going to be a G-suit, which is common to all fighters, and it's essentially very similar to what we're using on the F-16 back home in Norway, and it's designed to prevent the pilot from blacking out under G-forces. We also have a jacket, and this should be very similar to what our Finnish colleagues are flying in their Hornets today. It's a jacket which comprises survival gear, which is attached to it, oxygen and audio connections, and the jacket itself is designed to interface with the ejection seat to ensure a more safe ejection. Of course, flying over water that we will be doing in Norway, it has a life vest integrated into it. And at the end, at the top, you put on the helmet. And this is a relatively advanced piece of gear. This helmet replaces the head-up display, which is normally found in other fighter airplanes, which is the combiner glass that is positioned in front of the pilot. And that combiner glass normally presents information like altitude, airspeed, could be a targeting information, pointing out where different targets are. And all that information is now instead being displayed on this visor. So if you look, can look at the inside, you might be able to see there are two kind of tiny projectors on top there. And they are just that, projectors, and they're shooting an image which is reflected on the inner visor. So there are two visors. The outer one just functions like a pair of big shades, sunglasses, if it is bright, and it is bright here in Arizona. And this visor then is designed to both protect the pilot during ejection, so it's pretty sturdy, and also to reflect that image back. The airplane has more sensors than I'm used to, and every sensor is better, and then the airplane is designed to present that in one unified picture, so I don't have to spend time micromanaging the radar to look there, or IR to go search over here. The airplane is designed to fuse it into one picture. So you're being fed lots of information, and it comes for free compared to what I'm used to in FCC, where you have to work hard to build that picture. And then if you combine that understanding of what's happening around you with the fact that others have serious problems finding you, that's a tremendous advantage. So now we can choose to evade, or we can choose to attack, but it's on our terms. So that's a completely uneven fight. It's not fair at all.
Thank you.